गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय फिजिक्स क्लास। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज मोमेंटम। लेट्स स्टार्ट नाउ। मोमेंटम द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स व्हिच डिस्क्राइब्स द टेंडेंसी ऑफ ए मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स टू कीप गोइंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन विद द सेम स्पीड एंड इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मास एंड velocity of the moving objects. That means momentum is a property of the moving object. It is the quantity of motion, and momentum is the product of mass and velocity of the moving object. That means the magnitude of momentum is the product of mass and velocity of the object. Momentum is a vector quantity and its direction is as the direction of velocity. Velocity is a vector quantity and mass is scalar quantity. Therefore, momentum is also a vector quantity and its direction is as the direction of velocity. It is denoted by P and its unit is kilogram meter per second. We know the SI unit of mass is kilogram and SI unit of velocity is meter per second. So the unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second, and you know P is equal to mv. That means momentum P is equal to mass into velocity. Here m for mass and v for velocity, so P is equal to mv. Momentum describes the quantity of motion. Mass of the body affects the momentum of the body. That means larger mass, larger momentum. More the mass, more will be momentum. Momentum of larger mass of same velocity is larger. If this truck and this car moves with same velocity, the momentum of the car will be more than that of this car, because the mass of truck is more than the mass of car. So if these two, that is truck and car, moves with same velocity, then the momentum of the truck will be more. More the momentum, harder to stop the body. Velocity of the body affects the momentum of the body. More the velocity, more will be momentum. If the truck or car moves with high velocity, their momentum will be high. And if the velocity is less, then their momentum will be less. More the velocity, more will be momentum. Now mathematical problem. Two bodies of masses 500 kilogram and 100 kilogram are moving with same velocity of magnitude 30 meter per second. Which body has greater momentum? Here the mass of first body is 500 kilogram and mass of second body is 100 kilogram, and both these two bodies are moving with same velocity 30 meter per second. Which body has greater momentum? We have to determine it. Solution: here mass of first body m1 is 500 kilogram, mass of second body m2 is 100 kilogram, and velocity, that is common velocity, 30 meter per second. U1 is equal to what? That means momentum of the first body, and p2 momentum of the second body. But we have to determine P1 and P2, then we will compare it. We know momentum P is equal to M into V. For first body, we can write P1 is equal to M1 into V. And we know M1, mass of the first body is 500 kilogram and velocity 30. So if we multiply it, it will be 15,000 kilogram meter per second. The unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. And for second body, momentum p2 is equal to m2 into v. m2 is the mass of the second body and we know m2 is equal to 100 kilogram. So it will be 100 into 30, and after calculation it is 3000 kilogram meter per second. So momentum of the first body is 15000 kilogram meter per second and momentum of the second body is 3000 kilogram meter per second. So you can say momentum of first body is greater than that of the second body. Both these two bodies are moving with same velocity 30 meter per second, but the mass of first body is more than the mass of second body. Therefore, the momentum of first body is greater than that of the second body. So more will be the mass, more will be the momentum. Now, conservation principle of momentum. Conservation in physics, conservation means the condition before and after an event. That means the amount will remain same before and after action. If objects collide, their total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision. This is the conservation principle of momentum. That means if objects collide, their total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision if there is no external force. If there is no external force, then total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision, provided there is no external force. That is, there will have only action and reaction. Suppose M1 object is moving with U1 velocity and M2 object is moving with U2 velocity, and they are moving in the same line. Suppose velocity of the first body U1 is greater than the velocity of the second body U2. That means U1 is greater than U2. As they are moving in the same line, therefore, at a certain time, the first body will hit the second body. That means there will be a collision between these two moving bodies. As the velocity of the first body is more than that of the second body. So, after a certain time, they will collide. That is, M1 body hits the M2 body. And after collision, the two bodies will move with different velocities. Their velocity will be changed. Now, consider the changed velocity of the first body is V1. It was moving with U1 velocity, but after collision, its velocity is V1. And the velocity of the second body is V2. That is, before collision, the velocity of the first body is U1 and velocity of the second body is U2. But after collision, the velocity of the first body is V1 and velocity of the second body is V2. That is, U1 is changed to V1 and U2 is changed to V2. But according to this conservation principle of momentum, in this case, there is no external force. If there is no external force, then total momentum of first body and second body will remain same after the collision. That is, before collision, total momentum is equal to total momentum after collision. Now, total momentum before collision is equal to m1 u1. The momentum of first body is m1 into u1. We know momentum is the mass into velocity. The mass of the first body is m1 and mass of the second body is u1. So momentum of the first body is m1 u1 and momentum of the second body is m2 into u2. So total momentum before collision, this momentum plus this momentum. So m1 u1 plus m2 u2. This is the total momentum before collision. And total momentum after collision m1 into v1 plus m2 into v2, because after moment after collision momentum of the first body is m1 into v1 and momentum of the second body is m2 into v2, m1 v1 plus m2 v2. According to conservation principle of momentum, that means total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. In every collision, the momentum will be conserved. That means in every collision, total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision. Now, if the velocity of a body is u1 and velocity of a body, mass of the body is m1, then its kinetic energy will be half into m1 into u1 square, because if the mass of a body is m and its velocity is v, then its kinetic energy is half mv square. Kinetic energy means energy gained by a body due to its motion. Energy gained by a body due to its motion is known as kinetic energy, and we know kinetic energy is equal to half into mass into the square of the velocity. So if the velocity of the body is v and mass of the body is m, then its kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. So the kinetic energy of the first body is half m1 u1 square, and kinetic energy of the second body is half m2 u2 square before collision. So before collision, total kinetic energy half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square. Half m1 u1 square, that is kinetic energy of the first body, and half m2 u2 square is the kinetic energy of the second body. So before collision, their total kinetic energy is equal to half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square. Now total kinetic energy after collision is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square, because now the velocity of the first body is v1 and velocity of the second body is v2. So instead of u, we have to write v, u1 v1, u2 v2. So half m1 v1 square is the kinetic energy of the first body after collision, and half m2 v2 square is the kinetic energy of the second body after collision. So before collision, total kinetic energy, and after collision, total kinetic energy is half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Now, if the kinetic energy is conserved in this collision, then we can write, if the kinetic energy is conserved in the above collision, we can write half m1 is u1 square plus half m2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Momentum is conserved in every collision. According to conservation principle of momentum, momentum is conserved in every collision, but kinetic energy is not conserved in every collision. There are two types of collision: elastic collision and inelastic collision. In case of elastic collision, kinetic energy is conserved. So if the collision is elastic collision, then we can write this equation. Otherwise, we cannot write this equation. In case of elastic collision, we can write half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. In case of elastic collision, we can write this equation. If the collision is not elastic, then we cannot write this equation. That is, in every collision, momentum is conserved, but in every collision, kinetic energy is not conserved. In case of elastic collision, kinetic energy is conserved.